Greetings, fellow Earthlings, and welcome to this tiny garage. Many of you in the comments have asked me what manual I'm using to do the work on this car, because while it might seem like it at times, I don't know what I'm doing. And so I get the main gist of what I'm supposed to do from the Bentley Manual, which is a company that's been around for years. And this manual has been great. I don't know what I would do without it. It actually has color photographs, I know. And so this is the book that I have been using. Though this week is the end of where this book will take you with the Porsche engine. Once you get past cylinder heads, cylinder head gasket, replacing the Vario cam pads on the cams themselves, that's about as deep as it goes. And so while it is awesome, though slightly flawed, it is over. We are on our own. Now, what that means really is prior to now, I've been using the Bentley Manual heavily to try to get a gist of what I'm supposed to do. But then on top of that, I have found things that either it just doesn't mention or were mentioned very briefly and I needed more information. And so for that, I've been going to online forums, Facebook groups, just any kind of resource I can find. And so one of those resources is Hartech UK. Now, let me show you. I haven't opened this little gift box yet, but they're based in Bolton in England, which is 5,313 miles from here. Now, I was worried that these wider big end bearings, which they make over there, wouldn't make it here in time, but they got here, I don't know how they did it, in less than a week, which is like magic. Now, of course, that is special stuff, but in addition to that, they've also been tremendously helpful. Lee Jenkins and his team at Hartech UK, it would be difficult to find a group of people who know more about Porsche and Porsche engines. And that's a fantastic resource when you're doing something like this to actually just say, hey, what is going on here and how do I do this? And they will answer you. Now, there is a tremendous time difference between UK and San Diego. And even still, I find them really helpful to the point of making me little videos and stuff like that. So I kind of know what I'm trying to do and how I'm supposed to fit these little beauties into the engine. And so I would like to mention that if you are out there trying to get real answers to the questions that we have on these engines, someone like Lee Jenkins and Hartech UK, no sponsorship, I promise you, they've just been fantastic and you should call them if you have questions or if you want to buy these wider big end bearings to fix a known issue on the inside of these Porsche engines. Now, we are off the grid, and I do feel that if I had any worries before about not being a mechanic and not really knowing what to do, then here's where the problems are going to start for real. Now, I was telling my friend Amber about this, and bless her heart, she said, well, I'll help you. And so she's going to help. Now, I did ask her, hey, have you ever worked on a car before? And she said, like, never. She's never worked on a car before. And I said, perfect. So if any of us have any doubts about working on these cars, Amber's going to come along tonight and she's just going to do it. She says she's fearless. So let's get on with it. All right, step one, coolant temperature sensor. Are you ready, Amber? Okay, well, I consider that to be a yes. All right, so, oh, we're starting. Here we go. This is a 22 millimeter open-ended wrench. There we go. Knocking it to the left to break it loose. Lefty, loosey, lovely. Very good indeed. And that's it. And what's this? Oh, she's ending with a pose. All right, that's it. I'm doomed. You're never going to want to watch me do anything ever again. All right, step two, water pump. Now, this has seven 10 millimeter bolts. She was going to put them on the top of the engine. I told her to put them on the ground. I feel I might have cramped her style. I don't know. All right, working her way around there. You notice how Amber goes straight in with the electric socket wrench. And also her hair is tied back for safety. Safety first in the tiny garage.
I did miss one down the bottom there. So like I said, 710 mils in that feller. Now, important to mention, you see the two that are coloured white there? They are ever so slightly longer than the other ones, and you would want to know that. All right, let's see if we can get that water pump off, Amber. Yay! And there it is. And you'll notice that it has a plastic impeller on that water pump. Okay, the crankshaft position sensor. This is located at the flywheel side of the engine on bank one. I know none of you are hearing a word I'm saying right now. That's an H5 to get that fella off. Next up, we have the lower idler pulley. That's a 13 mil on that fella. And there it is, the world's most boring car part. Look at it. Okay, the coolant mounting bracket. Unfortunately, Amber is part of a competitive bungee jumping team. They had a meet tonight, and while I love to go to those meets, I had work to do. This guy just has 6 10mm in it.
Lee Jenkins of Hartech UK. We love you.
Mwah. Yes, thank you, Lee. Anyway, lower coolant manifold hose bank 2. Now, full disclosure, I made that name up. It's that one there. And while we're at it, you just need to buy one of these hose clamp tools. It was so cheap, I don't even remember how much it was. Something like $10 or $20, but it is a life changer. Also, while we're talking life changers, thank you again, Thomas Jodzio, and also more recently, Daniel Collins, for recommending this hose removal pick. This is my first time ever using it, and I'm no good at it at all, but even still, it was amazing and made me kind of feel like a superhero. Boom. Oh no, just when you think things are going well, I'm rotating the engine here. And as you know, NASA are doing some gravity experiments up in the International Space Station. I'm feeling it here every now and then, and we're about to witness an anomaly. Take a look there. Oh, you see that little fella? All right, couple of minutes on the ground searching around. That's what it is. I don't know what that is, but I do know that it's one of those things. Sort of helps the cylinder head line up to the block. Okay, coolant pipe bank 2. Again, I've made this name up. It is a coolant pipe. It's right next to bank 2, so that's why I named it that. Now, this one has 2 10mm on it. I can't screw this up too badly. Channeling Amber there with the socket wrench. And yes, that was pretty easy. Now, I did intend on taping up that screw in place in front of the camera, which happened to be over the engine's holes. Look. Oh man. And so at this stage, obviously I am contemplating life. And also, will my magnetic picker-upper thing fit in that hole? And it did. I just don't deserve that. But there we go. Magic. Anyway, finished taping that up, and while we're at it, that is not regular tape. I just so happen to have this Gorilla tape in the garage, and it's very thick and sticky, and it's more like very thick tape or thin tarp, and it's helpful for this kind of stuff. It won't rip. The oil filter housing. Now, I wish things could all be this easy. I know Amber would make it look much easier. If you are interested in that 74mm 14-sided wrench, check out episode 3. How can there be more oil to leak out?
If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like me to make more, the best way to tell me is to click that subscribe button.
Okay, coolant pipe rear, bank one. Again, another made-up name, but that is where it is. There are two coolant pipes. This is the other one. So rotating the engine there. Again, how can there be more coolant to leak out? I've rotated this engine dozens of times, and there's still new puddles on the floor. Again, how hard can this one be? We've got 3 10mm, but I'll let you in on a little bit of a secret. I don't know this yet, but that one right there that I'm undoing, it's different to the others. Oops, now do you see the confusion in my hand? All right, so it turns out, yes, I did sort of figure it out. It was that one. It has a washer, whereas the other two are shorter and they have no washers.
Hit the notification bell. It's up there.
Yes, please. All right, I feel a little better now. Thank you. The oil pan. I've already had this one off. That's why it looks so clean. It's not possible for me to mess this one up, right? So here we go. I'm like a superhero there because I've done it before. Truth be known, I kind of rounded out one of these bolts before, so I am being on best behavior. There are 13 10mm bolts in this oil pan. And there we go, it comes off. When there's no gasket, it comes off real easy. Okay, we are now officially off the reservation. The oil pickup pipe. Now, this engine is turned upside down. If you remember how confusing the Poseidon adventure was, then take a look at this. That oil pickup, which is the metal mesh pipe, I'm working on it right there, that is at the bottom of the engine, and that sucks the oil up from the oil pan into the engine to get used.
Hi, Pig Monkey. You're the best.
Yes, you are. Step 12, the air oil separators, or the swirl pots. They are returning the oil back to the pan on the left and the right for bank one and bank two. Their design is supposed to help remove the air from the oil as it returns to the pan. More about that later on. Oh no, you're kidding me. All right, looking like a superhero and... Okay. Oops. Like, what's that hole even there for? That looks very serious in there. All right, armed with my flashlight and the magnet thing.
Jordan, why aren't you here?
Yes, Jordan, why aren't you here to help me find that bolt? Okay, we're just going to keep moving on for now. The thermostat. I can't mess this up too badly. It's just 4 10mm bolts. They're all the same size. All right, and there it is. Now, if you look very carefully, the circle on the end of the thermostat says 83 degrees. So that means that is a stock thermostat. Okay, rotating the engine again here. Oh my God. NASA, stop it. Oh, wow. Okay, it came back out. I just don't deserve that. Thank you very much.
Unfortunately, that's all we have time for this week. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time. Bitchin'. Sorry. Yeah. Andrew Oakley.
Action.
Donna. Donna Esper, I miss you.